throughout the hour. My opening monologue coming up in mere minutes. Jay Sekulow will be checking in. Greg Jarrett at Henry. And so much more. Judge Jeanine Pirro, Andy McCarthy. But first, we go outside the Supreme Court where our own Fox News at Night anchor, Shannon Bream, she, of course, knows the Supreme Court well. She's covered it for years, is outside. Shannon.
Sean, it's a raucous night out here. We have folks on all sides of every issue out here, jostling, demonstrating, chanting, and now reacting to the pick that we have in Judge Brett Kavanaugh. He actually was a clerk for Justice Kennedy, actually a co-clerk with the man who is now the newest justice, Neil Gorsuch. So they may serve on this bench together now. He is a graduate of Yale. He's been on the bench, the federal bench, for 12 years or so, because now there's going to be a very long record for people to go through, sifting through his opinions, his decisions, his majority opinions, his dissents, and he's weighed in on a number of tough issues. One area to watch for a possible Republican objection, Senator Rand Paul, because this judge has ruled that bulk metadata collection does not violate the Fourth Amendment. That's something that Rand Paul has expressed his concern about. But he's got to win the 50 votes. He's got to make the rounds. He's going to start that on the Hill tomorrow. This is a guy who's run the Boston Marathon twice, and so he actually knows about running the gauntlet, endurance. He's going to need it getting through this because there are plenty of objections from the left, from folks who said from the beginning they would object to anyone this president nominated. So now we have the name. He will begin the gauntlet tomorrow. It is Brett Kavanaugh. He's got detractors on the left and right. He's got plenty of supporters. He has been vetted by the Federalist Society and Heritage. They say that they are confident in his conservative credentials. And so we'll see as he goes through the process. Sean, back to you.
All right, Shannon Bream, thank you for being with us. Joining us now is Fox News chief White House correspondent. He was in the room for the announcement. You've kind of been hinting all day because I've been watching your coverage, John Roberts. We kind of were all getting a little wind that, in fact, that was about what was going to happen. Although I see Shannon Bream in our shot. John, what is the big announcement? I have a lot of context, and especially at an administrative law conference at George Mason Law, and he actually almost said the very same thing in this speech on originalism, on separation of powers, on fidelity to the Constitution that he mentioned tonight. I'll read that later in the show. What's the first reaction?
Well, it obviously, by the people who are in the room here, it is a reaction of welcoming Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the nomination process. I think that there are a lot of people who thought that he was the perfect person for the job, with a long history at one of the most powerful circuit courts of appeal in the United States, the D.C. Circuit Court of Appeals. John Roberts was from the D.C. Circuit, as was Antonin Scalia, Judge Clarence Thomas, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Warren Burger, so many famous Supreme Court justices come from the D.C. Circuit. A lot of people thought, well, maybe it won't be Brett Kavanaugh because he is an alumnus of the George W. Bush White House. And, of course, the Bush family and the Trumps don't particularly get along. But George W. Bush sent a note out tonight on the nomination of Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court saying, President Trump has made an outstanding decision in nominating Judge Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court. Brett is a brilliant jurist who has faithfully applied the Constitution and laws through his 12 years in the D.C. Circuit. He is a fine husband, father, and friend, and a man of the highest integrity. He will make a superb justice of the Supreme Court of the United States. It's got an interesting story that the president really likes. Love the fact that his daughters call him Coach K. Now they're on to the nomination. Now they're on to the confirmation process, rather, Sean. And you know, that is going to be a bruising one.
A good point. Very predictable. I don't think it mattered. John Roberts, who, in fact, the president picked. I'll get to that in our opening monologue. John Roberts, thank you. Joining us right here on set, Fox News chief national correspondent. He's usually in the White House, but he's filling in the 8 o'clock hour. Like
trying
Brian Kilmeade, you're filling in every hour of the day.
Trying to give you a big lead in.
No, you did. This is what he said about revering the Constitution, about separation of powers. I'm going to actually read from a speech that he gave that, to me, it shows his judicial philosophy. At the end of the day, this comes down to originalism, constitutionalism. The president said the Constitution as written. Judge Kavanaugh has said the same thing many times.
Right.
And what's interesting here, it's very different than what the left wants. If Hillary Clinton had made this decision tonight, and she now picked her second Supreme Court nominee, it would be a very different philosophy, one of judicial activism.
And what the left is not mentioning is that this president was transparent and honest in 2016 about saying, I want originalists who will have a strict interpretation of the Constitution on the high court.
Like Scalia and Thomas.
Right. He named them. And Scalia and Thomas, and oh, by the way, put a packet together with 25 names and said, these are the people I'll nominate. So there's no mystery. It was transparent.
He was on the list.
And it was direct. Judge Kavanaugh was on the list. The DNC has just put out a statement, the opening line, I won't read the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Judge Kavanaugh should not be allowed anywhere near our nation's highest bench.
You know what's fascinating?
They would be opposed to anybody.
If they would have been opposed to anybody, there was nobody that he would have selected. By the way, I'm convinced that if the president gave every American $5 million, the left would still oppose him. But I think what's interesting, this is going to be a fascinating time. Basically, Dick Durbin said to every red state Democrat, Claire McCaskill,
Joe Manchin,
Heidi Heitkamp, Bill Nelson, all these people, we want you to commit political suicide.
Yeah, that it's more important to stop the president's court nominee, Dick Durbin said, than to worry about the midterm election. Tell that to Joe Manchin, West Virginia. Donald Trump carried that state by 41 points, not by 10 or 20, by 41 points. Now Joe Manchin is facing the voters in that same state. Couple quick points. The left is going to oppose this nomination. They're going to come out hard. They already are. I know Father Ensler, who was mentioned, John Ensler, that Judge Kavanaugh mentioned in Washington, D.C. He runs Catholic Charities. Judge Kavanaugh is somebody with a beautiful family. He works with Father Ensler to feed the homeless. And oh, by the way, he noted that he was hired to teach at Harvard Law School by Elena Kagan, who is one of the most liberal Supreme Court justices we've ever seen. So my point is twofold. One, Judge Kavanaugh, great family, strong Catholic faith. He's feeding the homeless with Father Ensler. He's hired by Elena Kagan, a liberal justice, to teach at Harvard Law. Nonetheless, the left will still find ways to go after his credentials. Number two, this president likes people, nominees out of central casting. He needed a defense secretary. He said, get me Mad Dog Mattis. He didn't like Tillerson at first. Get me Mike Pompeo. He's my vision of a secretary of state. In this case, notice the president said he teaches at Harvard, Yale, Georgetown. Central casting, going to be very hard to beat. Final point. Yeah. President's been telling people in recent days, Amy Coney Barrett is not out of the running. She's 46. Kavanaugh is 53. Give her a few years on the bench. If this president
I actually
has
had somebody quote him as saying she's next.
That she will be next. And they anticipate inside this White House they have at least one or two more picks before he's done as president. Mm-hmm. And so
you mean in 6 years from now? Between 6 years
Sean,
from now.
Sean, I'm a reporter. You're an anchor. I won't. You're exalted.
I won't ask you the question.
Here.
No, I know.
We'll see whether it's three more years or you know, six
All
or
right.
seven.
Great reporting tonight. Great job filling
Thanks,
in for Tucker.
Okay.
We're going to be joined by Jay Sekulow in just a minute. Ed, thank you. It is official. The president has now nominated Brett Kavanaugh to the U.S. Supreme Court. This is now the second time in 18 months the president will have and has the opportunity to send a judge to the highest court in the land. This is a lifetime position. This is a move that will shape the makeup of the U.S. Supreme Court now for decades and, frankly, generations to come. Now, all throughout the night, we will analyze the background, the judicial philosophy, which is so important, of Judge Brett Kavanaugh, and we'll also show you all the ways, predictably, that the Democrats will try to obstruct, once again, the president's, what is his constitutional duty. They will start, and it's already started, the smearing, the besmirching, the fear-mongering, and assassinating the character of Judge Kavanaugh. You saw him and his family tonight. You heard him in his own words tonight. We have over 300 opinions that he has written. He is considered a brilliant judicial mind. And also tonight, we have the biased, corrupt, anti-Trump FBI agent Peter Strzok. We're just giving you a preview of what's coming up. This is one of the busiest news weeks we will have. Strzok will testify in public on Thursday. Also, Lisa Page behind closed doors on Wednesday. And we also, as the president now, heads to Brussels and London, and then, of course, Helsinki to meet with Vladimir Putin. We will be in all three locations and covering all of it for you. This is going to be one of the busiest news cycles in years, so we hope you'll sit tuned. But first, tonight's breaking news. Yes, we have a new Supreme Court Justice nominee. Monologue is straight ahead. All right, we're going to talk to Jay Sekulow, the president's attorney, the chief counsel for the American Center of Law and Justice. Besides making a call, a president to send American troops into harm's way, This is now the most important decision a sitting president can make. President Trump has selected a second time in less than 2 years, President Trump has selected a nominee for the U.S. Supreme Court. And just moments ago, the president picked Judge Brett Kavanaugh to replace the outgoing Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy. Of course, this was not a surprise. In an unprecedented move, Judge Kavanaugh was selected from a previously released list of 25 originalist justices, making this just one more example of how this president is the most transparent president in history and also keeping a clear promise to the American people. Now, clearly, this was not a decision that the president took lightly. Now, President Trump, in many ways, there's political aspects to this, and he had to thread a political needle. And by the way, he has to think about senators like Collins and Murkowski. And then on the other side, Senator Ted Cruz of Texas, Rand Paul of Kentucky. In other words, pick a judge with a very narrow margin in the U.S. Senate who could also successfully maneuver through a confirmation hearing and garner the votes from a majority of senators. Without a doubt, Justice Kavanaugh is an extremely qualified candidate. Educated at Yale, Kavanaugh clerked under Justice Anthony Kennedy, just like Neil Gorsuch. In the 1990s, he served as an associate counsel for Ken Starr. That, of course, during the investigation into then-President Bill Clinton. During that time, it was interesting, Kavanaugh did push a controversial opinion that Bill Clinton had, in fact, obstructed justice by sometimes making false public statements or sending surrogates out to do such about Starr's investigation. Judge Kavanaugh, in a very interesting piece that he talked about in 2009, he did change course and he publicly changed his opinion on the issue of obstruction. What was a very powerful article that was in the Minnesota Law Review. We'll go over that in more detail. In 2006, he was appointed by George W. Bush to serve on the U.S. Court of Appeals for the D.C. Circuit, where he amassed a lengthy record of very key, important decisions. It's considered one of the most important courts in the land, including multiple opinions against the overreach of then-President Obama's EPA, other opinions that, in fact, bolstered our Second Amendment rights. One point of concern was Judge Kavanaugh's mixed track record on one issue, Obamacare. But after years on the D.C. Court of Appeals, what is his originalist and constitutionalist track record is fairly extensive and fairly robust. And by the way, to all you never Trumpers out there all across America, you tried so hard to prevent a Trump presidency. Are you happy tonight at all?